Alright, what's up guys? It's Greg here today, bringing guys a Call of Duty Black Ops 2 gameplay commentary. We're going to be playing some 9 vs 9 team deathmatch on Hijacked. The score limit goes up to 200, so this is a 77-3, and I'm using the Lodestar. So this is on Plutonium, which you can unlock everything if you want, but I like to level up, I like to unlock stuff. That's kind of like the way I've always enjoyed playing Call of Duty. I like progression in games, and it gives me something to grind for. I always enjoyed the grind, not just going in and stomping people. I think that, honestly, the grind is the actual fun part of COD, but I know a lot of people disagree with me, so yeah. You'll see that the majority of people are Prestige Master on this game, and they don't use any sort of, they don't like to level up, basically. But Plutonium has brought back a lot of memories that I really, really liked about Black Ops 2. And I just need to say, real quick, pardon my trash aim on PC. I have not played a consistent game, like PC shooter, on PC since, oh my goodness, 2015. So it's been about 5 years of degrading muscle memory, so yeah. Occasionally I'd hop on and play, but I never really, you know, played for long on keyboard and mouse. And I really miss it, but controller is where the content's at for Modern Warfare, so I'm going to try to grind Black Ops 2 for you guys again on Plutonium. If you guys want to see me or anybody else that also plays Plutonium, feel free to download it. If you guys do need a setup tutorial video, I can make one of those. Just let me know in the comments section below, and we can go ahead and get you guys underway to play Plutonium. I don't know if you actually need to have the base version of the game for PC to actually play it, so I think it's free for everybody to play. And I just want to say this real quick, I really hope Activision does not shut this down, because they did with the Modern Warfare 2 client years back whenever IW4X and other things were created for reasons like this, with server browser, FOV sliders, all this kind of stuff to bring back the good games and stuff like that. Also, yeah, I like to talk a little bit of some weird shit in chat, because that's just funny to me. Probably, you know, makes you guys roll your eyes, but funny as shit to me. Anyways, yeah, so the thing about it is if they shut this down, like if Activision comes out here and is like, no, we can't have this game because we're not profiting off of it. Honestly, you guys are disgusting at Activision if you do that. And here's why. There's RC exploits, I think that's what they're called on PC, which allow people to hack your computer, they allow them to expose your personal information, all this kind of stuff. And guess what? Activision doesn't patch it. Alright? They don't go back and take care of these older games. They just let it happen. And, yeah, if Activision actually wants to shut down a client that actually cares about the game and bring life to the older games, then I think that kind of speaks volumes about Activision, right? Corporate greed, anyone? But yeah, why even charge people for a game if there's these unsafe exploits out there that can completely ruin somebody? I mean, their computer could ruin their files for work, it could ruin, could get someone killed, forbid, if someone leaks your address and stuff, you know? I mean, it's pretty dangerous, this kind of stuff that can happen with the RC exploits. I've heard all kinds of things that happen with it. But of course, you know, Activision doesn't care. The only thing they see is dollars, not any sort of privacy, safety, or anything like that for their consumers. So, yeah. I think this needs some more population on it, this game, because the connections are really iffy. There's a lot of people playing from overseas and U.S. lobbies, and there's a lot of people on EU servers that are from the U.S. because not a lot of players. I feel like people just don't understand how to install it, and I really feel that installing it is a very strange and weird process. Also, I really wish they would have higher server tick rates, but it is free to play. So, you know, I don't really think we're going to get the most expensive servers out here, especially ones that have good netcode and tick rates. So, yeah, just whenever you come onto this game, don't expect to, you know, slap kiddies up and pub stomp real hard. Just expect to have some fun, reminisce the good days of Black Ops 2. That's kind of the whole point of it. Don't take it too serious. You know, just have some fun. That's what it's about. If you come on here expecting, you know, to play it exactly as it was back in 2012, 2013 with decent connection and fair gunfights and all that kind of stuff, yeah, you're not really going to get that. This is more just a way to re-enjoy this game without this type of cheats and all that other kind of stuff. And, ooh, love the butter knife in this game. But yeah, it's just a way to reminisce the good days and play the game again, which I really am happy it's here, and I'm going to keep playing it. I'm going to keep grinding it out for some content and stuff like that for you guys. And I would love to see you guys on this game. You know, we get to chat in game and have some fun, maybe snipe, you know, do all different kinds of things. Like I said, I'm not really all that great on keyboard and mouse anymore, so I have a lot of grinding here to do, and I think it'd be fun, you know, to see some of the people that watch me, as well as new people. And just to make friends and stuff like that on an older game, and just have some fun reminiscing the days when COD was a lot of fun. Yeah, I'm not saying Modern Warfare isn't fun, but they really broke the game with the new update for PC players, and I hear they even broke some stuff for PlayStation players, which, you know, they got that multi-million dollar contract with Sony, so holy shit, I can't believe that. But, yeah, Modern Warfare, Infinity War is just an indie game studio, I swear to God, and, yeah, they're just really disappointing me with how they break things with their patches. But anyways, the gameplay's coming to an end. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you guys want to see more Black Ops 2. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Let me know if there's anything I can improve on in the comment section. And I will see you all in the next video. Peace.